Namaste students, so let's begin our physics class. Today we are going to start a new chapter, chapter number 5, light energy. Now children, in the previous class you have already studied that the light travels fastest in air. Speed of light in air is 3 into 10 to the power per 8 meter per second. But when the light enters in another medium such as water or glass, the speed of light decreases. The speed of light in water is 2.25 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, while in glass it is only 2 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. So in the language of physics, if the speed of light in a medium decreases, then that medium is said to be optically denser than the other medium in which the speed of light is more. Like here, glass is said to be optically denser than water and air because the speed of light among these is minimum in glass. Or we can say that air is optically rarer than water and glass because the speed of light is maximum in air. So if the speed of light is more, then it is called optically rarer medium as compared to the other medium where the speed of light is less. Then it is called optically denser medium. So there are two types of medium, optically rarer medium and optically denser medium. If the speed of light decreases, it is called optically denser, and if the speed of light increases, it is called optically rarer medium. Now, we have studied in the previous class of the rectilinear propagation of light, that light always travels in a straight line. But this happens only when the light is traveling in one medium. When a ray of light traveling in one transparent medium falls obliquely on the surface of another transparent medium, it travels in a direction other than the direction of its initial path. So this change in the direction of the path of light when it passes from one optically transparent medium to another, that is called refraction of light. Then the direction of light changes when it goes from one transparent medium to another transparent medium, that is called refraction of light. Like this, this surface is separating two media, air and water. Air is optically rarer medium, water or glasses are optically denser medium. This is the ray of light falling on the surface of the medium, separating the two media. Now, this light, instead of following the straight path, it bends towards the normal, where normal is the line perpendicular to the surface boundary, separating the two media. So, the light, instead of going straight, it bends like this. Similarly, when the ray of light is going from denser to rarer medium, it is, see this ray of light, it is falling at the surface separating two media, air and water. Water is denser than air. So when the light is going, instead of going straight, it bends away from the normal. So children, you have to remember this point. When the light goes from rarer to denser, it bends towards the normal. And when the light goes from denser to rarer, it bends away from the normal. And one more very important thing, if the light falls perpendicular means at 90 degrees, then how will it pass? Suppose this is the surface separating two media, air and water or glass. Now, this is the normal. Normal is a line of 90 degrees. Suppose a ray of light is falling normally, like this. This is a ray of light incident. It is falling normally, that means angle of 90 degrees it is making. Then the light will pass straight. It will not bend. So when the light is falling normally, it will pass undeviated. Undeviated means no change in its path. It will pass on straight to the other medium. Now some important terms related to refraction of light. Suppose I have drawn a diagram when the ray is going from rarer to a denser medium. So it is bending towards the normal. Now, the ray which is falling on the surface separating the two media is called the incident ray. This is called the incident ray. The ray of light traveling in the other medium in the change direction, this OB, this is called the refracted ray. The perpendicular drawn on the surface separating the two media at the point where the incident ray strikes this point, this is called the normal. And the angle between the incident ray and the normal is called the angle of incidence. And the angle between the refracted ray and the normal is called the angle of refraction. Always the angle of incidence and angle of refraction are taken along the normal. Now, there are two laws of refraction of light which are also called as Snell's laws. The first law is that the incident ray, the normal at the point of incidence and the refracted ray all lie in the same plane, like in this diagram. This is the incident ray, this is the normal at the point of incidence, and this is the refracted ray. They all align on the same plane. Here the plane is of the board. It can be the plane of paper, the plane of table, the plane of wall. Now the second law is that for a given pair of media and the given color of light, the ratio of the sine of angle of incidence I to the sine of angle of refraction R is always a constant. Means this, for this pair of media, the sine I upon sine R will always remain constant. When we will change the refracted incident ray to any other direction, if we change I, the angle R will also change according to that, such that sine I upon sine R will always come to be the same value. And this constant is also called as refractive index. It is denoted by the symbol mu. This is called mu. And if the ray of light is traveling from one medium to another medium, then one more formula for refractive index is that, which is mu equals to speed of light in first medium and speed of light in the second medium. So in terms of angle of incidence and angle of refraction are mu equals to sine I upon sine R. And if the light is going from one medium to another medium, then you take mu equals to speed of light in first medium upon speed of light in the second medium. And one very important thing, the value of refractive index mu can never be less than 1. It is always greater than 1 if the light is traveling from air to glass, because mu equals to sine I upon sine R, and also mu equals to speed of light in air. If the light is going from air to water, suppose, then mu will be speed of light in air, which is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, to speed of light in water or glass. Suppose glass. So it is 2 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, which comes out to be 1.5. So it can never be less than 1. It will always be greater than 1, because the numerator will always be greater than the denominator. The speed of light in air is always greater than the speed of light in any other medium. Some effects of refraction of light. The depth of water in a vessel when seen from air appears to be less. Why is it so? It is due to refraction of light, the bending of light on the surface. Suppose this is water contained in a container, and this is a point O which is at the real depth of water. This is the real depth from the surface to the bottom, real depth of water. Now a ray of light which goes in a straight line, which falls at 90 degrees, it will pass on straight, undeviated. But this ray of light which falls obliquely at this point, it goes away from the normal, because the light is going from denser to rarer medium. Now if you are standing here, you are viewing here, you always see light in a straight line due to rectilinear property of light. So this point seems to be raised up here. You will not observe this point, you will see this point. So the depth seems to be up to here only. So it appears less. So this is the apparent depth and this was the real depth. Similarly, if a coin is placed at this point and you view from here, it will seem to raise here. So this is due to refraction of light. So children, this is All for today.